Hey, how's it going? I'm Yo, that's Steve-O, and we're here today to talk about zombies rising up from the ground. Dead Island, new game for Xbox 360, the platform we're reviewing it for, recently released, and Steve-O, huge zombie fan, so it only seemed fitting that he would be the one to tackle this particular review. So tell us about your experience on Dead Island. Not the best vacation locale.
No.
So don't put it on your places I must visit.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. This game wasn't even on my radar as far as games to get with Gears of War 3, Madden. So many games all around us that this wasn't even really a game I was interested in until I started reading more about it. The basic idea of Dead Island 3 is take Fallout 3, take Borderlands, take Left 4 Dead, and you squish them all together, and you have this fantastic first-person shooter RPG on an island filled with tons of zombies that want to eat your brains. So
yeah, which is their food of choice for some reason. Yeah. They should just go for peanut butter sandwiches. But one of the things that you've been talking about that was really interesting is the multiplayer aspect.
Yeah.
How you can drop in and out of someone else's game, or they can drop in and out of your game. And the benefits of doing that, they got a really cool system for that.
Yeah, one of the best multiplayer ever, in my opinion, for any video game. The system is amazing. I can be in a campaign, rocking it by myself, and if a friend is in my area, or just another random person, it'll ask, hey, you want to join up with this person? You know what? Sure, why not? You join up, it saves your progress exactly where you were, you can quest. In fact, if you're further along in the story, you can request with them, you know, so it's pretty easy. I've done that a few times with some friends, and you still get the experience again, you get the quest rewards again, so it's very beneficial. And when you're done, you can just drop out. It saves your gear, your experience, everything you've obtained in multiplayer, and puts you right back where you were in the campaign.
That's really cool that
Brilliant.
You can do that.
Yeah.
To drop in and out, and then pick up right where you left off and get all of that experience. I mean, that's a really cool setup. What are some of the other gameplay mechanics? Because one of the things that you've talked about is how well the game is put together.
Yeah.
We'll get to content here in just a moment, but how well it's put together. What are some of the other mechanics that stand out and make you think, this is a great gaming experience?
Yeah, well, it's very customizable. You can play as one of four people. Each person has their own individual talent tree. So if you're used to an RPG, say World of Warcraft, it was very easy for me to jump in. Okay, survival, combat, some great abilities there. I love the mechanics of the customization of weapons. You can find maps. In fact, today I just found the Molotov map.
Ooh.
So I need two bottles of alcohol and a rag, and now I can start burning zombies. But anyways, yeah, so there's some great stuff in there as far as weapon customization. You can carry up to six weapons at a time. I love, love, love that you have an inventory slot of weapons. You only get 12 to start with.
Right.
However, as far as items in the game, like duct tape or deodorant, which if you put together makes a bomb, I don't know how that
duct
happens.
Duct tape and deodorant makes a bomb, kids. Don't mess around with that stuff.
Exactly. So, but you can get as many as you want. There's unlimited for the amount of items that you can carry.
It sounds like MacGyver on Zombie Island is what it sounds like.
You know what? That's exactly what it is. Yeah. I made a baseball bat with metal blades that spin out of some barbed wire, some saw blades, and a bat I had found lying around.
The MacGyver survival horror game.
Incredible.
Now, of course, the game does deal with the zombies, so there are some content things to keep in mind. It's an M-rated game, so you gotta lay some of that out for people as well, so they know what they're getting into. Just how gnarly is some of that?
Yeah, well, when I popped it in, I was hesitant to even want to do a review of it, because the very first word out of the gate is the F word, and we're not
talking
about...
Which we won't repeat.
Yeah. Lots of that, lots of using the Lord's name in vain, a lot of gore, obviously. Pretty much everywhere you go, somebody's being munched on by a zombie because it was an island resort.
Or zombie heads are exploding in a shower of blood.
Yes, yes.
I've seen screenshots and videos where some of the resident zombies are wearing bikinis.
Yep.
Which is not a pleasant thought.
Yeah, it's kind of hilarious because you're battling zombies in bikinis and board shorts, basically.
Board shorts.
So pretty much everywhere all over the beach. So, yeah.
So those zombies are like, dude, watch brains, bro. Okay, so how would you rate this game? Now, obviously, it's a tough one for us to do as Christians because you have that whole issue of content. But the game is a well-designed game.
Absolutely.
The structure of it is great, but then you have the content issue. So how do you reconcile that, and what would you tell people? Obviously, we're not recommending people to run out and play a game with a bunch of foul language and bloody zombies. How do you do that?
As a video game, it accomplishes so much. The multiplayer aspect is amazing. The leveling RPG system is absolutely incredible. I'm loving the campaign. The voice acting is so-so, but you can press the B and skip that, so I'm totally cool with that. Overall, as a game, as an achievement in video gaming, I give this a solid 6 out of 7. It is absolutely brilliant. Mm-hmm. However, the content, I give it a big fat 0 or 1 maybe, because it's very gory, lots of language, and so I'm not necessarily recommending it, but wanting to let you know that it is an accomplishment, and man,
basically what you're hoping is that some of those elements that they put into this game structure might find its way into other games to enhance the gameplay experience of other games, which is always nice when you see that kind of innovation going on, like the drop-in single-player multiplayer thing. I hope that makes it into some other games. It'd be awesome. Alright, so there's our review of Dead Island. You can read more about the game and some of the content issues at GameAndMovieGuide.com. And, of course, you can always share your comments at Facebook.com/GameAndMovieGuide. And, all right.
Zombie shirt!